Hi everyone and welcome back. So we have seen how to create a containers from a Docker image. In this video we will see how you can create a Docker image from a Docker file. Okay, first of all let's see what actually Docker image contains. Docker image is nothing but your custom set of instructions, like you want base image Ubuntu. Now you will install Redis, you will install Nginx, and you will convert that into Nginx container of your own. You are using the base image Ubuntu, you install the Node.js, GitHub, Git, all these required set of tools on it, and you converted that into your own Node.js image. You can see here, this is base image is Ubuntu. I will talk about the instructions, what all are written, like from. From is nothing but it is actually instruction which is saying that I will start with this base image. Because all the containers are nothing but a minimal Ubuntu, minimal Linux containers, right? They will be extending either some of the Ubuntu distribution. So here we are extending Ubuntu latest image, right? Then we have the next command is label, which is just a maintainer, like if you want. And then run command is actually used to run the specific commands. You already know that when you log into Linux, you can just run these commands: sudo apt-get, update apt-get, install git, install nginx, and all these commands. So I'm installing nginx, first I'm upgrading it, updating it, and then I'm installing nginx application. It is a web server. Then I'm exposing port 80 from that container. So once this container will live somewhere, it will expose port 80 to talk to the outside world. And then finally, because Nginx is already installed, so I should be able to run Nginx command. This is a runtime command which it will execute. So it is actually default. If you have an entry point, then it will look for it. Then otherwise, it will look for the command instruction. In the command instruction, we are running this command. So what will happen once you build this container? And what need to be done to build this Docker file? Sorry, I'm using container word. It's a Docker file. So you have to do Docker build and Docker file name. So currently the Docker file is in the current working directory. I will do dot, and you can see what it is doing is it is getting the latest Ubuntu image, then adding the label. So for every step it is going to create the layers on the image, then it is installing Nginx. Once all the things are done, our image will be ready to be consumed or to be created as a container. Okay, it's running. So it is installing Nginx and up running these two commands. Okay, and it will expose port 80 and finally run the Nginx from there. Okay, so this is basic Docker file, and we created Docker image from the Docker file. Okay, now it is completed. So if you just see Docker images, I will show this here so we can see things clearly. Yes, so we should be able to see hello world node, and we created one image. So what is the image name we put? So now to run this container, right? So this is Nginx container we have created. It should be Ubuntu only, I think. We can see when this image is created. Created 15 seconds ago. Okay, we don't put a name here. So that is a problem. We will have to put it. Now to run this container, what you can do is docker run. You can also use container ID. Sorry, image ID. So it will just run, and when it is running it, what will happen is it is actually executing these commands to run it. Nginx, and it is exposing port 80 from there, right? So here from this Docker file, what we did is docker build t. What it is doing, it is converting and it is giving us the container, right? So if you just see docker images, we are able to see this image ID. Now to actually run this image ID, what it is doing is now we have to explore more concepts about it. How we can access something which is being exposed from a container through the port mapping? It is actually running Nginx. So if we just do docker run, or if you just run this particular command, docker run image id, what it will do is it will start service which is running inside a container, but there is nothing which is being exposed to the outside world, right? In this particular case, what should we do? We have to do the port mapping. So I will just stop this container, docker run minus p, and port mapping will be 80 of container port will be mapped to the 80 of host port, and then run this particular container. Now it is doing nothing, but it is actually exposing the port 80. It is actually mapping the port 80 of host to the port 80 of container, and we should be able to see things running on our port 80. You can see the Nginx page is coming now, because port 80 of host is connected to the port 80 of container, and this particular container is running Nginx. From Docker file you can see it is running Nginx, it is actually starting Nginx and exposing port 80. We have installed Nginx on it, right? So this is how, from Docker file, we are creating Docker image, and then we are converting or creating the instance of Docker image and creating container out of it.